This video is number 7 in my series of accessories for the Spike fermenters. This particular video is going to cover the sight glass. So let's start by talking about the sight glass itself right now. This thing is sturdy, let me tell you. It is pretty much bomb-proof, I think. Very rugged, yet very simple in its construction. Easily taken apart, cleaned. So the handling and the product itself, really, really top-notch. The question is, how are you going to use it? What I'm going to do is change the configuration on the fermenter here to a couple different setups so you can see ways that I've used it before and whether or not you really need or want to have this. So hold tight, let me change things around, and we'll be right back. Now this configuration is probably the most popular one. Essentially, you just put it on the bottom of the cone of the conical. And it's kind of neat, kind of fun, because when fermentation is taking place, you can see that yeast just churning away, and it's neat to watch. It also does another thing in that it extends the neck of the conical lower. So if you're dry hopping or have a lot of sediment that's starting to build up on the bottom of your fermenter, this allows it to sink much deeper. On the bottom, we have the output port there so you can dump your tube and yeast and whatever. But like I say, this is about the most common setup that you'll see. Fun, not really needed, but it's a way you can use it. Let me show you one more that's kind of handy. Okay, here's the final configuration, and it's just a little different, and let me explain what we got going on. I added an extra butterfly valve up here. I've got the original one down here in the bottom. I have a dump port here coming off the bottom, probably kind of hard to see. But essentially with this setup, I can transfer the wort in to begin fermentation. This guy's open, so this will all be filled up. Once I'm ready to do my tube dump, I can easily get rid of that, see it transfer out of here, close it back up, and then when I'm ready to actually harvest my yeast, instead of transferring it out, I can simply close that off, take off the whole sight glass. It'll be like a glass full of yeast. So pretty easy to use. So as you can see, the sight glass gives you some flexibility. It's kind of fun to use. To be honest, I don't use it all the time. In fact, I'll go so far as saying I seldom use it. But as far as having an extra gadget to use with the fermenter, it's certainly something to consider. So I'll leave it up to you whether you want it or not. Is it nice to have? Yeah, kind of nice to have. Do you really need it? Absolutely need it? No, you don't. And you can always add it later. So that's it for the sight glass. That's it for this series of options for your fermenter. I'm going to post them all. You see the links in the description below. You can take a look at any one of them whenever you want. Thanks again for watching. Best of luck to you.